property tax is the most burdensome tax. We need to provide some property tax relief. It starts with the state stopping the practice of claiming it's cutting spending and providing tax relief, while it's really just pushing costs down onto local government and shifting taxes off sales and income and onto property tax. So that's the first thing. We have to stop pushing costs down onto counties and local governments, like, for example, by not reimbursing counties for housing state prisoners. The second thing we need to do for ag land, agricultural lands, is we need to lower the valuation from 75% to 65%, because land prices went up dramatically, the earning capacity is simply not there, and it's become an enormous burden on farmers and ranchers. At $3 corn, it's just impossible to pay the property tax and still have enough to make it work. Finally, I would take some steps to beef up our state property tax credits, where we use alternative sources of revenue to reimburse taxpayers through their income tax payment system for property taxes paid. We have a property tax credit now that reduces the property taxes owed, but it's not well targeted. For example, right now, the biggest beneficiary in Nebraska of our property tax credit system is Ted Turner, because he's the largest property owner. And I have to believe that Ted Turner doesn't need property tax relief nearly as much as many of our family farmers and ranchers and many of our modest income homeowners. So what I would like to do is develop a property tax credit that is targeted toward modest income homeowners for whom property taxes are taking an unreasonable percentage of their income, a so-called circuit breaker, and then also target the agricultural land relief in that credit to family farmers and ranchers who own and operate their farms or are retired from owning and operating their farm.
So my four-point property tax relief plan calls for, one, putting more money into the property tax credit relief fund. That's a direct relief from the state to all property owners in the state. It's a line item on your property tax bill. You can see it right there. The second thing is, and this is important, curtailing the unfunded mandates that the state pushes down to counties and school districts, whether through regulation or services, because that puts additional burden on property taxes. The third point is to take valuations on ag land down from 75% to 65%. Last year, we saw the average ag land valuation across the state go up 30%. That puts a huge burden on our producers, our farmers and ranchers. And then my fourth point is we need to put a cap on how fast those valuations can go up, so that we don't run into the situation in the future. All those are things I think we can tackle in the first legislative session next year.
We need some property tax relief real bad. We in Nebraska, I know we pay more taxes than anywhere. I know people that move out of town just move out of state just because the taxes are too high. They get some money and they go because they think they're spending too much money here. We do need relief. And I mean, the marijuana legalization, that'd be a great income source, you know, additional revenue source. As far as taxes too, I had another great idea to spur our economy that I think we should make a tax exemption available for all products made or produced in Nebraska to produce economy within, and to promote our job, our economy from within the state, produce goods and manufacture goods here in the state instead of buying it from China or out of our state. We don't want that stuff from China. That's ruining our economy. We want to build an economy here. And what's our economy is here going good and everything's going good. The taxes, the taxes are going to make up for itself because we're bringing all this more money in, and it's going to be great.